Namaskara, Bangaluru.
I am Shailraj Brambat, and it's my pleasure to invite you all to this Elite Club Conclave, specially reserved for our lifetime subscribers. Today, I am actually feeling very nervous. It's a similar feeling that I've had when I was getting married. When I was on stage, I had many people, my in-laws, looking at me with a lot of expectations. It is something similar that I'm facing today. But I'm sure I'm going to go through this the same way I went through my marriage. And a lot has changed from then and now. You know, there are lots of changes that have happened since then. So let me come to that shortly. Before that, let us start with a quote from our favorite investor, philanthropist, our favorite speaker, Mr. Warren Buffett. He's aptly said that the best investment one can do is an investment in himself. The more you earn is because the more you learn. So it is the more you learn, the more you earn. And that is the reason why we believe an in-person connect on a regular basis should be done with all our customers, especially our lifetime subscribers. And that is why we organize these events, so that we can discuss new ideas, share the treasure of all investment strategies that we have, and make sure that you all are prepared, well prepared, for any eventuality that the market may throw at you. Before I start, let me start with a story. Are you all okay with the story? Okay. So the story goes that there was this very powerful king long time ago, and it was his birthday. So he invited all his friends and his acquaintances for the party. After the party, when he was opening the gifts, he found a box. And what did he find in this box? In this box, he found a note which said, "This too shall pass." Reading this, he was furious. He was angry. He was like, "Why is somebody mocking me? That too on my birthday?" So he called his guards and asked them, "Make sure this person is behind bars before the end of the day." The guards followed his rule, and they arrested this person. It was so to happen, a few days later, the neighboring kingdom attacked his kingdom, and this king was put behind bars. And now when he's pacing up, upset, troubled, with the sudden change of events, he reaches to his pocket. And what he finds in the pocket is this note. This note which read, "This too shall pass." But this time the feeling that he had was different. What was so different? He felt consolation in this message. He felt that this message made some sense. Luckily, this king's army did a counter-strike and were able to free the king in a few weeks' time. As soon as the king was made to come in power, what he did was he released the person, the sage, who had sent him this note and made him one of his counselors. The root cause of all our disappointments is because we fail to understand the impermanence of things. I understand there are people, including myself, would be very upset when the markets are going down. My portfolio is in the red. Everything is correcting. But it's easy to forget that the bulls and the bears are temporary. We get deviated, swayed away from the initial idea that we started this investment with, the discipline that we had promised ourselves that we'll follow because of these. So that brings me to today's theme. The theme of the conclave is, change is the only constant. What next? Let me give you a basic gist of what we'll be seeing in today's day. Across the day, there are a number of speakers, number of experts, who will be taking you through the changing times of Indian economy, the growth story of Indian economy, how your portfolios have been performing, which I'm sure you all are aware about, and also will give you new ideas and new strategies that you can take back with you. during this event, there is a very important announcement that we will be making, and there is a surprise. Yes, you heard it right. There is a surprise. We are going to be unveiling a secret, but that will happen at the end of the event. Now, without wasting much time, it is time for me to call upon stage a person who's been a pillar of strength, the driving force, a mentor to all of us, especially at Research and Ranking. He is someone who has a singular focus right from inception. It is wealth creation through investing in equities. He is someone who has been around at all times for us and made sure that we are on our path. Let me invite on stage somebody who is silently revolutionizing the way a modern day investor invests. Let me call upon stage, and I would request you all to give him a standing ovation and a big round of applause. I'm inviting on stage our founder, director of Research and Ranking, Mr. Manish Goel.
Thank you, Shailraj, for an amazing introduction. I'm used to it now, though. Thank you all for being here today. Today, I would like to divide my speech into four parts, all parts, as I believe, are very relevant. Number one, testing times. Number two, hand-holding. Number three, trust. And number four, way forward. Testing times, number one. We always say this, and data also proves the same. Equities as an asset class is the best performing asset class. As a retail investor, I invest my hard-earned money into equities with an understanding that I will be able to grow it at a faster rate as compared to any other asset class. But is it true? Looking at how equity markets have done over the last 1.5 years, looks like it is not. Looking at how markets have done over the last 5 years, looks like it is true. So, where's the gap? See, if you ask me, is there any formula, you know, that could tell me how to make a profitable investment? I would say yes, there is a formula available that could tell you how to make the most profitable investments. If you ask me, is my expectation wrong if I expect my investment value to grow every year? I would say no. Your expectation is not wrong. If you are expecting your investments to grow every year, or let's say on a regular interval. So, as I said, where is the gap? Let me introduce the concept of testing times today. It is 100% true that equities is the best performing asset class. As an investor, I can make so much more in equities, which is not possible if I invest into any other asset class. But the catch here is it doesn't move in the upward direction always. If you know, if I had started my journey as an investor in the year 2014-15, the return I would have got in one single year would have been in the range of anywhere between 80 to 90%. In some cases, probably more than 100%. We have been around for 10 years now, you know, as a group, and we have been advising clients on their investments in 2009. We launched research and ranking in 2016, and the returns we delivered to our clients in 2016-17 and 17-18 have been in the range of 35 to 45%. So if an asset class has the strength to deliver 80 to 90% in one single year, it will go through a consolidation phase at some stage and test your patience as an investor. And if you could survive such testing times, then as I said, wealth creation by investing into equities could happen at a much faster rate as compared to any other asset class. It is because of such testing times that many start believing equities is not worth considering as an investment option and lose out on the big gains that come as soon as the cycle turns. Part two of my speech, hand-holding. So obviously, the next question I would have in my mind as an investor, what should I do to get through, or let's say survive, such testing times? At Research and Ranking, we have been advising our clients to do the following. Read a lot. I would repeat, very important, read a lot. To know about the quality of the businesses that you are holding in your portfolio, and to understand and to know what and how these businesses have performed for the investors over the last 10, 15, 20 years. It may not be a bad idea to read about the economy and as well as what is happening around the globe. Watch as less news as possible. Try to stay away, especially from those one-line headliners / breaking news that keep telling you what is happening wrong around the globe on an hourly basis. Try not to act upon the advice given by a friend or, you know, given by family members, if it is not backed by exhaustive research and if fundamentals of the businesses are not known to you. I said it last time and I would like to repeat it again today. Do not take leveraged positions. And this holds true even when you are making good money on a regular basis. It is not during testing times that you should not be taking leveraged positions. I'm saying do not take leveraged positions even when times are good. Ask a lot of questions to your advisor. As I said, we have been advising our clients. We have been handholding them, educating them. So when we receive queries during such testing times, we reply them mainly by highlighting these two points. During such times, it might look this way that movement in price is everything and fundamentals have no value. But it is not true. If a business has delivered 10, 15, 20 times, 50 times, 100 times upside over last 10, 15, 20 years, it should not be judged basis its underperformance or negative performance over a short period. We highlight the importance of looking at the bigger picture and try to explain the concept of wealth creation as much as we can. Number two, we expect our clients and we advise them to look at the portfolio in its entirety. During such testing times, what will happen, which is happening currently, some businesses will go down in terms of their price movement. Some businesses will go down much more than their intrinsic value for a short period of time. So do not look only one or two businesses or three businesses how they have done. Look at the portfolio in its entirety. Part three of my speech, trust. Even though last 1.5 years has not been very good in terms of market performance, we have been able to grow our business by more than 100% in this period. And this has happened mainly because investors do have this realization now that there cannot be a better time than during such testing times to start your wealth creation journey if you have a long-term view. So as an investor, I should be making use of such testing times. If I'm a long-term investor, there cannot be a better opportunity than this to start my wealth creation journey. People do have this realization now. We do come across mainly six types of clients in research and banking. First set of investors, they would like to understand everything about every business we recommend. They would like to understand each and every data point given in every report, which is good, which is very good. Second, they would like to compare the performance of R&R portfolio with the portfolio they are already holding. So it could be either a mutual fund portfolio or a portfolio which I have created. And if R&R portfolio is doing better than my existing portfolio, then it is good. And if it is not doing as good as my existing portfolio, then probably R&R is not doing justice with the job. So there is no harm doing this way, but the period should not be less than 1 year or so. People do make a mistake when they try doing it on a very, on a very short-term basis. Like I bought R&R recommended stocks today and I would like to compare the performance in 1 week, 10 days, 1 month. That is not how it should be. Third set of investors, they will not buy everything recommended by R&R. They will just buy a few stocks out of the recommended portfolio. And allocation also, they will only decide, without going for the R&R recommended allocation. Fourth set of investors, they will track the portfolio on a very, weekly basis or monthly basis. And only if it is growing continuously from the month one itself or week one itself, then they'll be happy about it. And if there's some downside in first 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, then they'll not be very happy about it. And fifth set of investors, people who will not do anything. They bought R&R portfolio because I felt like buying it at that time. The wealth counselor happened to impress me. There was some offer going on, or there was some reason, or something changed at my end, you know, which I was not aware of earlier. Sixth set of investors, people who will do everything as recommended by R&R. They will buy all these stocks, follow the recommended allocation, buy, sell, exit, hold, everything as R&R is recommending, I'm doing it that way only. We respect all six types of investors. We don't expect anyone, to change their perspective on day one itself. Yes, as an investor, as a client, you will take some time to understand, our investment methodology, why we recommend something, why we recommend a sale, why we recommend an exit. And slowly and gradually, it gets better. So initially, if 30% of our clients fall in first five categories, gradually we have seen probably 80% or 90% start falling in the sixth category. So that number from the first five categories, if let's say in first 6 months it is 30% or 40%, it reduces to only 10% or 15% by the end of 6 month or 7th month or 8th month. Why I'm saying all this? Because if you follow everything recommended by R&R, then only the best results can be expected. And since we have seen it in our experience that this number from the first five categories reduces from 30-40% to 10-15%, so it says it all. What is more important over here is, as I said, there's nothing wrong if I ask questions from my advisor. But ideally, I should not be doing it in hindsight. If we look at how mid-cap, I'm talking about Nifty 100. I'm not talking about the other one, the mid-cap index. I'm talking about Nifty 100. If we look at how Nifty 100 has done over the last 5 years, it has delivered about 104% upside, which is much more than 76% upside delivered by Nifty in the same period. And this is despite negative 15% delivered by Nifty 100 and plus 7% or positive 7% delivered by Nifty in the last 1.5 years. This rally in Nifty in last 1.5 years has not been a broad-based rally. Only 8 or 9 stocks have contributed to this upside. If we remove the performance of them, then even Nifty has not delivered, there's no upside in Nifty as well over the last 1.5 years. One more interesting observation could be, if we look at, Nifty stocks over the last 1.5 years, and if we talk about any stock which has delivered good upside, let's say TCS. TCS has done about 66% in last 1.5 years. And if you talk about one negative performing stock, it could be anyone, let's say Maruti. Maruti has done negative about 30-odd% in the last 1.5 years. You will be surprised to know that if you look at how Maruti has done over the last 5 years, it has delivered about 190% or 180%, which is much more than TCS upside over the last 5 years, which is only about 90-95%. So we are not trying to conclude here Maruti is a better company or TCS is a better company. Obviously, I'm not trying to give any recommendation or not trying to conclude anything that which company out of the two is good. But what we are trying to conclude over here is wealth creation is a slow process. Some companies, some sectors will outperform this year. Some companies will probably grow next year. As long as fundamentals of a business are good and you have a long-term view, let the effect of compounding kick in. This underperformance, overperformance over a short period of time, yes, it could be there. It could be there. In hindsight, I might think this way that, oh, I should have bought TCS, not Maruti 1.5 years back. It's possible. But as I said, Maruti has done 200%, TCS has done only 100% if I look 5 year chart. So, and it's okay. Whoever bought TCS 1.5 years back, why not? It was a good investment made. But what I'm saying, some sectors, some companies will grow, will outperform other sectors, other companies this year. Some will probably do it next year. So what is more important over here is look at the bigger picture. Read as much as you can to know about the fundamentals of the businesses that you are holding in your portfolio. And if you are satisfied, I am holding a good company, I am holding a company which has delivered 10, 15, 20 times or even more than that for the investors over the last 5, 10 years, 20 years, then let's not worry. Let's not worry about such testing times. Let the effect of compounding kick in. And as I said, ask questions to your advisor, no problem. But trust him more. Once you have been able to conclude, they have been doing things, recommending you businesses in your best interest, with an objective that you create wealth over a period of time, let them do things as they believe is right. Just be with them. Just be with them. And try to fall in the sixth category of investors I just talked about as soon as possible. Because if you fall in any of the first five categories, and first category of investors who ask a lot of questions, they want to understand every data point and every report, no problem, do that. But at the same time, try to fall in the sixth category of investors to get the best possible results. Last part of my speech, way forward. So R&R has four key pillars: research, technology, personalization, and education. Research, as part of research, we do a lot of micro analysis, which is country level, I would say country level, and a lot of macro analysis, which is global level. To understand what lies ahead, to understand what trends are emerging in our own economy as well as in the world economy. And I would like to reiterate, next 10 years are going to be the most exciting times for India. This I am saying despite the fall of few businesses in the last 1.5 years. Still I am saying the next 10 years are going to be the most exciting times for India. Now we all know what is wrong with the NBFC sector, for example. Now we all know loans are piling up with various corporates. We know the fate of the likes of Jet Airways, ILNFS, DHFL, and many others, which are probably not yet fully wiped out, but finding it difficult to meet their obligations. Has this all happened in the last 1.5 years? Or was the cleaning process done too fast? We believe this has not happened only in last 1.5 years. We believe this was building up in the system from last many years and needed to be looked at. We don't think if it could become a systemic risk now, but we believe it could have surely become a systemic risk if it was ignored for some more time. Yes, I know, as an investor, you know, all of us had to go through a lot. Yes, I know, because of fall of, you know, these businesses and because of this negative news flow, you know, I get panicked. There's a lot of anxiety, a lot of distrust in every investor's mind. So it is not that we are expecting revival, you know, will happen tomorrow. Revival will happen gradually over a period of time. We don't believe this could become a systemic risk from here on. Rather, we believe this is the best available opportunity, or one of the best available opportunity for a long-term investor. Please buy selectively and do not take leveraged positions. Please don't get panicked. We know a lot, and we have gone through a lot in the last 1.5 years. Please don't get panicked. This was building up in the system from last many years and needed to be looked at. This has not happened in the last 1.5 years alone. Do not get panicked. Use such opportunities or such times to buy for long term. Revival will happen. It will happen gradually, but revival will happen. There's two things, as I said: buy selectively and do not take leveraged positions. Our second pillar, technology. At Research and Banking, it is the way of life for us. We have been building more robust solutions with an objective that we bring more and more ease, you know, in your investing experience and how you do things with us. In a while, Gaurav will talk about the solutions we are planning to implement over a period of time to ensure that your investing experience becomes more exciting and hassle-free. Education and personalization. We all are here today. It is a part of our education initiative. We create a lot of videos and try to, you know, keep in touch with you in many different ways to ensure that, you know, to ensure you should never feel unattended. We are planning a lot more on this front, and yes, technology will help us big time in pushing this objective. Let me assure you, there will be a time when very soon when you will find we have given you so much in your control that you will feel someone is there 24/7 for you to answer to all your queries. We are planning to implement such solutions. So all I can say, fasten your seatbelts. The most exciting time in your wealth creation journey is about to begin. Do not lose this opportunity, because the next one may not be as exciting as this one. You are at the right place, at the right time. So there is no reason why you should be delaying it. Thank you.